Okay, we hope that we've established our connection with Inspirit, and a little feedback would be helpful. And we've got about 2.5 minutes before showtime. So tell us, please.
Can you hear us out there? Can anybody hear us? I think maybe it's going to show up over on the side.
Okay, I'm going to do this. Hey, Patty. Hey, Renee. I hope you can see us. We can't tell yet if you can see us, because we don't see ourselves yet on your site. But hopefully.
We don't have regular contact with grandchildren, so we're not sure how all this, you know, comes together.
But we have a minute and a half, and we're going to start singing. And hope that someone yells at us if you don't hear us.
Why can't we see that on the computer?
I don't know. But we did this before, and it worked.
I have confidence.
So, we hope you can see us and hear us. And in 1 minute.
Shall we play a...
Looking good. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. we're doing this off of a tiny little phone, and it's a little bit far away from us, and it's a little hard to see. So I hope that you can hear us too, but I think you would say we can't hear you if... sounds good so far. Okay. I think...
Are we ready?
I think we're ready.
Okay.
And it is 1:59. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6,
T-minus.
5. I don't have a second hand. I'm lying. 4, 3, 2.
It's 2 o'clock.
Oh, right.
It's 2 o'clock.
I forgot to mute my computer.
Yeah.
It'll just tell us when it's 3.
Okay.
So.
Okay. So hi, Jenny. Hi, Jenny.
Hello. Hello. Thank you for tuning in. This is Bill, and I'm Joan from PinkSlip Duo, and we are here and sponsored by our favorite nonprofit, Inspirit.
Inspirit.
The mission of Inspirit is to bring live performances to those living in restricted environments, people who can't get out to the bars anymore. And these days, that's essentially everyone.
All of us.
So that means that we're not going to limit ourselves to the songs we typically do only for our typical Inspirit audiences. We're going to play songs for everybody, or at least try to. So here are 18 of our favorites from between the 1800s and the 2000s. And with a Pink Slip show, you'll have to expect a little bit of education to go along with it.
Are you going to do that every time we get a message?
This one is giving us instructions. Bring them on camera.
Oh, we're not on camera yet?
I think we are. So I'm going to, I think you should introduce the first song.
Okay.
And hope that it's going okay.
Okay. Our first song comes from Canada. The song commemorates 18th and 19th century clashes between French rebels and British colonial forces who punished French rebels with either death or forced exile from Canada. The song's lyrics describe a banished rebel who longs for Canada. Un Canadien errant was written in 1842, and it's an important patriotic song for Québécois, Acadians, and other Canadians. It's been recorded by Ian and Sylvia, Leonard Cohen, Theodore Bakel, and Paul Robeson.
And a quick shout out to Cy and Rona, our friends from Toronto, and Manny Young and Cote St. Luke Club in Montreal. And if the Lipsons are tuning in from Paris, you might like this song because it's in French. And another thing I think we should keep in mind is people who are being deported, and like dreamers and others who have spent their whole lives here, and what it's like to be banished from the only country you know and love.
Oh yeah, that could be the exact same sentiment.
It could be, even though it's written in the 1800s.
In French. Ready?
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Our next song is called Shukun, and it comes from Haiti. And a shout out to our Haitian friends who are listening today, Joe and Guy. Its original Kreyol verses, written in 1883, speak to the bitterness of a man who loses his girlfriend to a lighter-skinned guy who's recently come to town. But its racial content got lost in translation in English as Yellowbird.
You can fly.
Missy.
In January 1948, Woody Guthrie read about a plane crash in Los Gatos Canyon in Fresno County, California. The crash killed 29 migrant farm workers and the crew of the plane. Woody was incensed at news reports that neglected to give the names of the migrant workers, referring to them only as deportees. He wrote a poem to them which contains symbolic Latino names for the victims.
Nearly 10 years later, school teacher Martin Hoffman wrote music for the poem, and 65 years later, in 2013, not too long ago, descendants of the deceased migrant workers raised money for a single large headstone etched with all 28 names. It was unveiled at the Holy Cross Cemetery in Fresno, California on Labor Day in 2013. And hopefully this song will remind us to appreciate, especially now, all the people who pick our produce.
Starting the drum?
Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. No. Crops are all in, and the peaches are rotting. The oranges piled in, their creosote dumps. They're flying them back to the Mexico border to pay all their money and to be back again. My father's own father, he waded that river. They took all doo-wop hit, Come Go With Me, was written in 1956, so we've come from the 1800s to the 1950s now, by a member of the Pittsburgh band that made it popular, the Del Vikings. And as I mentioned, Pittsburgh, I'll do a shout out to Roy Connors, who's not quite from Pittsburgh, but not too far away. And my sister-in-law, Pam, who I think is tuned in, is also now a Pennsylvanian. Doo-wop was first developed by black teenagers in East Coast and Midwest urban centers, and because they often couldn't afford instruments, many of the doo-wop songs were a cappella. Soon, Italian and other white kids formed doo-wop groups, but doo-wop groups remained largely segregated. One rare exception was the Del Vikings. Needs to get a harmonica.
Already did.
Okay.
For What It's Worth, ranks number 3 on Rolling Stone's list of the top 10 protest songs.
I think we've entered the 60s.
Where did the years go? Stephen Stills wrote it after, and we're talking about For What It's Worth now. Stephen Stills wrote the song after witnessing the 1966 Sunset Strip curfew riots in L.A. But because of the times that it was released, it quickly became associated with demonstrations against the Vietnam War, and it charted at number 7 for Buffalo Springfield in 1967.
The Summer of Love.
The Summer of Love, except on Sunset Strip. We are.
Vietnam is not the only thing we associate with the 60s. We all probably have at least one song we associate with Woodstock. This one is mine by Canned Heat. And Canned Heat came on at 7:30 p.m. Saturday night on Woodstock weekend back in 69. And this is called Going Up the Country. And if you're curious where some of these weird noises are coming from, I'm playing a keyboard that has some settings that allow it to sound like not just a piano. And I'm going to be playing a flute in this one.
A flautist.
Let's see, no keyboards. Okay, ready?
Ready. Also gave us the British invasion. It was hard to choose our favorite from among the Beatles, Dusty Springfield, the Searchers, Billy J. Kramer and the Dakotas, Peter and Gordon, the Dave Clark Five, the Animals, Chad and Jeremy, Manfred Mann, the Zombies, Marianne Faithfull, 2 O'Clock, Herman's Hermits, Freddie and the Dreamers, the Moody Blues, Rolling Stones, the Kinks, Donovan, the Mindbenders, the Yardbirds, the Troggs, the Hollies, Boo Boo, the Who. But our choice for today was Jerry and the Pacemakers and their ode to Liverpool, Ferry Cross the Mersey.
Wow.
You couldn't hear this song without thinking of the British invasion. And I need to set the drum here.
Oh, I'm sorry. I should have done that.
Now we're ready.
Okay. Wow. What a look at all those British groups. It's incredible.
Yeah.
What a
and we probably left a few out, too.
Probably. Oh, we'll hear about it. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Life goes on day after day.
The 1960s was also the birth of folk rock, including the Mamas and Papas. Lead singer Baltimore native Cass Elliot was originally named Ellen Naomi Cohen by her Russian Jewish parents, Philip and Bess. California Dreamin' was written by John and Michelle Phillips during a cold winter in Greenwich Village when they longed for the warmth of LA. We had a lot of fun arranging this to sound like more than just the two of us. And Bill carried it off perfectly. A shout out to my friend Corey in Southern California. Oops, I need a flute again. Okay. Renee correctly reminds us that she too is in California, but we saved a different song for you. So, okay.
Okay, here we go.
Moving on to
Paul Simon's classic hit, America, considered one of Paul Simon's greatest composing achievements. A 2014 Rolling Stone magazine readers poll ranked it fourth among Simon and Garfunkel's best compositions. And the magazine observed, "It captured America's sense of restlessness and confusion during the year that saw the assassinations of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and Robert Kennedy, as well as the escalation of the war in Vietnam."
Thank you.
1930s Christian hymn that maybe you didn't know was a Christian hymn. It became a big hit in 1972 by British singer-songwriter Cat Stevens, now known as Yusuf Islam since his conversion to Islam.
Thank you.
County, Kentucky, where the Everly Brothers and John Prine's family are from, is mining country. And when the mines run out, they're bulldozed over along with the towns where the workers had lived. We sang this song with a childhood friend of the Everly Brothers in Central City, Kentucky, at the tiny Everly Brothers Museum. John Prine grew up in Chicago, but he visited family in Muhlenberg County on summer trips. And we're doing this song as a tribute to John Prine, who was taken by COVID this year.
Contemplates the consequences of messages taught to children about war and other social issues. He said in an interview, "If we don't start teaching our children a better way of dealing with each other, we're effed, and humanity itself is in great danger."
Become yourself, because you have.
The popular 1984 hit, Boys of Summer, charted at number 5, won Don Henley of the Eagles the Grammy for Best Male Rock Vocal Performance, and is on Rolling Stone's list of the 500 greatest songs of all time. We chose it basically because I like it. So there you go.
That's fair.
Keep the 3.
Oop, 35B. I got it wrong.
No. 24 was right.
Oh, I just cost us several minutes.
Oh, man.
Gotta go out to 165 now.
Yeah, this happened to us yesterday.
So, got any good folk singers jokes?
Just banjo jokes, Roy.
Keep 03.
Hold on. I've decided to change my orchestra sound. Uh-huh. Impulse. I like this one better than the one I've been using. Okay.
Strings.
1, 2, 3, 4. Adeola Samuel, better known as Seal, was born in London to a Nigerian mom and an Afro-Cuban dad, although he was raised in foster care. Seal wrote the song Kiss from a Rose in 1987, but he didn't dig it. In fact, he said it embarrassed him and he tossed it into the corner. He finally showed it to his producer and recorded it 8 years later, like in 1995, and it topped the charts in the US, the UK, and several other countries, and won him Grammys for Record of the Year, Song of the Year, and Best Male Pop Vocal Performance. It was used in the film Batman Forever and sold over 8 million copies. And we, with this song too, enjoyed the challenge of trying to arrange it for a duo.
An aging duo.
Speak for yourself. Okay. Ready? Esta canción por Mark Anthony y Corey Rooney fue escrito primero en inglés como I Need to Know y después en español
como Vendímelo en 1999. La versión en inglés ocupó el número 3 en el Billboard Hot 100 y la versión española ocupó el número 1.
Uno, I know that word.
And this is goes out to my amigos latinos. El número 1 en los Hot Latin Tracks.
Song by the late Debbie Friedman, who was known for writing Jewish songs and prayers using both English and Hebrew. Mishaberach is probably the most well-known of her songs. It's named Mishaberach. It's sung at Jewish services all over the country. The song calls for physical and spiritual healing, so it's a good one to sing right now. Here's Debbie Friedman's Misha Bayrock.
And this goes out to everyone who needs spiritual or physical healing. Maybe that's all of us. And I'll say hello to BJ, who I think is tuning in. And I think we first sang this song for Congregation Beth Adam. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you. This popular song was written and recorded by Canadian Avril Lavigne in 2002 and made into a hit by Kelly Clarkson in 2004. It was also featured in the film Princess Diaries. Okay, who all saw Princess Diary? Hands? Okay. It's a song about making a change in your life.
And this is the song that always makes me think of Renee, who's had so many changes in the last 2 years, more than I think anyone could normally bear or deal with. So many changes. All right, we good? Yeah. One more, and we sure want to thank Inspirit for supporting musicians and keeping live music, well, alive. And thank you, Ginny and Renee, thank you very much. And thank you all for tuning in, and take very good care of yourselves, and take very good care of each other. Thank you.
John Lennon, and we admire his noble vision to imagine a better world. But at this point, we're going to close with Willie Nelson's approach to altering
the... I wondered if you were going to do that.
...to altering the status quo.
Thank you.
Be sure and vote.
Hope it stayed connected.
Vote them out.